The Missile Defense Agency and the U.S. Navy will test a new variant of SM-6 missile designed to counter specific types of hypersonic threats. The plan will see the missile taking on an advanced maneuvering threat, a term that's been used in relation to unpowered hypersonic boost glide vehicles, or HGVs. As per reports, the new variant of SM-6 missile, named Block 1B, is already under development for this purpose and will itself be able to reach hypersonic speeds. This will create a whole new dimension to American military capabilities and help it protect its important assets like supercarriers from Chinese and Russian HGVs. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes how the U.S. plans to defeat hypersonic glide vehicles with SM-6 Block 1B missile. Let's get into the details. This video is sponsored by the free-to-play military vehicle combat game War Thunder. We talk a lot about military vehicles on this channel, but what about trying them out for yourself? In War Thunder, you can choose from more than 1,200 playable vehicles from the 1930s to the 1990s and go to battle on more than 80 theaters of war. You can fly aircraft, helicopters, drive tanks, and command ships of all types and sizes, which have been carefully recreated from their real-world counterparts. It's available as a free download on PC, PlayStation 4, and Xbox One with cross-platform support. So grab your friends and give it a try. All viewers of Defense Updates that register using the link in the description below will also get a free premium tank, aircraft, or ship, and 3 days of premium account time as a bonus. Barbara McQuiston, a senior U.S. official currently performing the duties of the Undersecretary of Defense for Research and Engineering, stated in written testimony, MDA, the Missile Defense Agency, in cooperation with the U.S. Navy, demonstrated early capability against maneuvering threats during flight testing of the Standard Missile SM-6 Sea-Based Terminal SBT defense. And it will further demonstrate this capability against an advanced maneuvering threat representative target later this year. We will continue to advance our SBT capability to address the regional hypersonic threat and will test that capability in the FY 2024 timeframe. Viewers may note that the U.S. Navy currently uses the Aegis Missile Defense System for missile defense. The Aegis Missile Defense System is a United States Department of Defense (DOD) missile defense agency program developed to provide missile defense against short to intermediate range ballistic missiles as well as cruise missiles. Aegis-equipped vessels like Arleigh Burke-class destroyers can shoot down enemy missiles in the terminal flight phase by expanding the Aegis combat system with the addition of the AN-SPY radar and Standard Missile or SM technologies. The system will likely be enhanced with the new variant of SM-6 to counter HGVs. An object is said to be hypersonic once they exceed speeds of Mach 5, or 5 times the speed of sound. This is about 1,715 meters per second, or 3,836 miles per hour, or 6,174 kilometers per hour. There are currently 3 methods being applied to make hypersonic weapons. The first is through the use of ALBM, or air-launched ballistic missile. As the name suggests, this kind of missile is ballistic in nature, but is launched from the air, unlike traditional ballistic missiles which are launched from land or sea-based platforms. The second is a scramjet engine. The scramjet is an innovation on the ramjet. Ramjet engine can power flight to supersonic speeds, but scramjet can enable the missile to reach hypersonic speeds. These engines have no moving parts and rely on the huge pressures created by fast airflow into the engine to ignite the fuel and generate thrust. In this method, a rocket booster is used to accelerate the missile to hypersonic speed Then the scramjet engine kicks in and enables the missile to fly at sustained hypersonic speed. The third is using HGV, or Hypersonic Glide Vehicle. In this method, the system is launched to extremely high altitudes using a ballistic missile or an aircraft, where it skips across the Earth's upper atmosphere. The vehicle then separates from the carrier and glides back to the Earth towards its intended target, attaining hypersonic speed. This is the type that the U.S. Navy hopes to overcome using SM-6 Block 1B missile. Russia and China are the only countries to have HGVs under limited operational deployment. In 2018, during the State of the Nation address, President Putin had unveiled several new weapons, and one of them was Avangard. At that time, Mr. Putin had described it by saying it heads to target like a meteorite, like a fireball. Avangard has been deployed using a UR-100 UTT-KH ICBM. And in one of the tests, it reached a speed of Mach 27, as per Yuri Borisov, the Deputy Prime Minister of Russia. China has developed DF-17 missile, along with DF-ZF HGV. Dongfeng-17 is a Chinese solid-fueled, road-mobile, medium-range ballistic missile that mounts the DF-ZF hypersonic glide vehicle. The DF-17's hypersonic armament gives China significant leverage over current conventional weapons due to the glide vehicle's unpredictable ballistic trajectory. The DF-17 and DF-ZF were officially unveiled at the National Day Military Parade on the 1st of October 2019. The RIM-174 Standard Extended Range Active Missile, ERAM, or the Standard Missile 6, SM-6, have been deployed by the U.S. Navy to counter different kinds of threats. It was designed for extended range, anti-air warfare, ERAAW, purposes, providing capability against fixed and rotary wing aircraft, unmanned aerial vehicles, anti-ship cruise missiles in flight, both over sea and land, and terminal ballistic missile defense. It can also be used as a high-speed anti-ship missile. The missile uses the airframe of the earlier SM-2ER Block 4 RIM-156A missile and some targeting elements from AIM-120C AMRAAM. It can discriminate targets using its dual-mode seeker, with the semi-active seeker relying on a ship-based illuminator to highlight the target, and the active seeker, having the missile itself, sends out an electromagnetic signal. SM-6 has a max speed of Mach 3.5 and has a 140-pound or 64-kilogram blast fragmentation warhead. The Block 1B variant is expected to see some major upgrades to propulsion and guidance. It's to be noted that America's Government Accountability Office, GAO, report, released some time back, has stated that the U.S. currently lacks the defense required to protect against the latest crop of hypersonic weapons being developed by China and Russia. The report states, China and Russia are pursuing hypersonic weapons because their speed, altitude, and maneuverability may defeat most missile defense systems, and they may be used to improve long-range conventional and nuclear strike capabilities. There are no existing countermeasures. In its response to the GAO, the Department of Defense described the report as an accurate, although sobering, macro picture of how the U.S. stands in the world against emerging threats. This situation is expected to change with the introduction of the SM-6 Block 1B missile. Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.